Welcome back, everybody. I'm Absurdum, and this is more Metal Brothers. I'm so excited to be back. I know it hasn't seemed like a long time for you guys, because it was probably just yesterday that you watched, but for me, it's been 2 weeks. I was out of town, and I had to record a boatload of episodes just so you guys can get one every day, and that's exactly what I did. Last time I started recording was actually all the way back to Season 2, which was a long time ago. And since then, I've gotten all kinds of great advice and tips and, you know, here's what you could be doing better comments, which I absolutely love from the people who have been watching. So I'm really excited to try some of that out. On top of that, I got like 20 some subscribers in the last like week, which is, for me, is huge, and I'm really excited. So for everyone who has been watching and sticking around, subscribed, thank you. I really, really appreciate it. Because I know 20 subscribers isn't really a whole lot, but to me it's a big deal. In fact, it was like 50% of what I had. So I'm excited for all the new people to come. Some new people came in, so they want some people named after them. So I have their names written down in order. I believe I got everyone. So when we add people, we can do just that. But we left, and I spent the last probably about 20 minutes or so going over all the advice I've kind of gotten, seeing where it fits into where I am right now, and recapping what exactly I left us at, and I left us in just a sad, sad shape. I remember that we went out, and it's like, hey, we can fight this thing. I don't want to skip what could be really cool things I find just because I'm afraid of what might be there, right? And it was adventurous, and until those ghosts came in and started really destroying our morale, I think we were doing okay. I felt like we were holding our own, but I just couldn't get them to go away, and typically I had better chances before hitting them. I know they kind of changed them in the latest patch to be harder to hit, and I felt it. I couldn't hit them. I couldn't get them to disperse, but it's what happened. So here we are. We have some bandages, thank God. We are probably going to have to sit out for a while and just heal, which I really don't want to do because that's time and money wasted, but we are not in the shape to fight. Some of these people have cracked skulls, and I mean, their skills are just destroyed. They go out there, they're slaughters. They're lamb for slaughter. But looking at everybody right off the top of my head, I think we are okay to sell some of this equipment, try to get some of our money back. On top of that, bows, huh? I don't know, I'm thinking about maybe switching Vincetti over here to Archer. Haven't really done a whole lot with skills yet. I'd rather have him have this. I was building up to be melee. I don't know. I'm just undecided, because his melee skill is going to get so much better. Or his range skill, not his melee. And I think maybe we should kind of push him that way. I don't think I was before, but it's hard to say. I'm having a hard time remembering. But one of the pieces of advice I got, and I think this is a really great and probably obvious choice, is to kind of focus more on... I was putting a lot of time and focus on raising fatigue so I could put heavy armor on people. But I should be putting more into melee defense, especially for these frontline guys. It just seems like a really great idea, and it's going to do more for them than, say, initiative or even fatigue at a certain point. So that will be a big change I make right off the bat. Another thing would be, instead of trying to save up money to buy really expensive armors, which get expensive and out of hand really quickly, spend it on just better tiered people, which just have better stats. There's some decent ones that you can get for cheap. I don't know if I've really spotted any here. Let's see. I'll sell some of these things, because I don't think I need all of them. I would like to try to get back whatever money we can. I don't think we need that either. I'd like to keep more shields and equipment than I do, but some of that stuff we can do without for right now. So let's take a peek down here. I doubt I'm going to hire anybody just because I'm low on money and I can't take a job. But right here, this is the kind of talk we're... Like, we're just under being able to afford him, but somebody like a retired soldier would be a solid choice. Butchers, Hound Masters. So if we had a little bit more money, we could totally jump on all these guys, which would be really, really great. Not sure, again, what really defines this money. I think it's the armor. This guy's really cheap, but he doesn't have a hat. This guy's more expensive, but he has a full set of armor. So I'm imagining that's what it's about, but I'm not positive offhand. Someone else also commented to me at one point. I just remembered, you know, instead of trying to save up to buy armor, you can buy these guys, take their armor, which is usually worth more than what you're buying it for. Equip to the guy you want and just dismiss him if you don't like him. But typically that won't be the case. I do like these guys better. But like this armor here is, you know, probably about the same cost as that. Someone said that you have to pay a fee to discharge people, which I've never done. The only way people get discharged out of the Death Eaters is by dying, as well as all my other companies. So, not positive of that. But for now, let's just continue on what we're doing. That was a lot of freaking noises. Let's see if we can find a temple, because I wouldn't mind spending... Oh, there's one right there. Perfect. So I wouldn't mind spending some cash. Yeah, what is this now? So roll up some maps, blah, blah, blah. Are dragging Miss Yuku across the ground. Happened. Now there's a lot of dirty words in this. They're having a hold your breath contest. Okay. So what did we get for this? Everyone's in good spirits, except for Miss Yuki. Miss Yaku. Who is not so pleased about almost drowning to death and apparently hurt themselves in the process. I guess that's a nice random event. It's interesting. Anyways, we need to spot this tavern here. I don't have a tremendous amount of money to go about healing people. But some of the more serious things like this has to be taken care of. Somebody else had a cracked skull too, I believe. Pierced cheek, I'm not so concerned about. It sucks, but it's not terrible. Car arm, also not great by any means. Yeah, these cracked skulls are terrible. At least this one's cheaper to heal. But that puts them completely out of business. This also is not very good, but we're getting low on money. I'd take or leave that. You're a frontliner, so I'd really like you to have your defense. You know, it might just come down to the whole fact that we need to really take some time and kind of heal on our own. Not travel. There's some jobs here. Hopefully we can take one, get a nice advance on it. We're okay-ish on food. I'd hate to sell more things. We can do it. Just don't want to. Especially since we're not getting a good price for some of the stuff. Like this right here, I'd really like to keep. But right now the money I think is more important. Same with this bad boy. I'd love to keep it. That could be someone's injury. He's healed right there. Just one person healed. And now a lot more effective in 2 days. And us going to battle over it and taking a job instead of waiting and kind of just draining what it is we have. Shit, another fractured skull. Maybe the shit out of us. Well, everything else, with the exception of Gizmo's windpipe, I mean, I would like to heal that. 2 to 5 days, it's pretty long time. If the other ones heal up, though, in a couple days, we could be back at it very shortly. It might be time to sit a bit. And, God, we're low on money. Maybe just take a nice, cozy escort job, which none of these will probably be because they're 2 stars. Delivery heading out to Gorg. What kinds are we talking about? 400 when the contract is done. Northwest. So it's heading the direction I want to go, I believe. Let's see. Some time to think about this. Oh, I'm so excited to play this game. I'm just so bummed I left myself in such a crappy spot. I wonder which way this cart would try to go. It might go up here and then try to cut through. I might just try to go all the way around, which wouldn't be terrible. I have money for 4 days, which is... Oof. It's oof. What's this other one? Okay, so you have bandits. Back out, man, so he's blah blah blah. Kill the brigands, if you wouldn't mind. Bring back the property. I do like those quests a lot. They're pretty simple as long as the necromancer is involved, and as long as I don't have to betray anybody to get that sweet, sweet betrayal money. I did do that in season 2, and it was... God, the guy offered me like 3 grand for 1 grand quest, and I was like, ugh. I didn't want to do it, but just the money was right. Didn't matter. So there's this, which I would love to take as well. But with everyone still hurting, I just don't think we can get away with it. That doesn't mean I won't. I'll tell the guy no, because I'm definitely not going to tell the guy no. Braille coin collection. All right, so let's take a quick look at everybody and their other injuries and see when these cracked skulls and the liking. I would really like to heal your leg, but it's going to heal in 2 days, so 2 to 4 days. So it's still some time before these are going to heal. 2 to 5. God, everyone's just got a freaking cracked skull, man. That wasn't a cracked skull. That was a broken nose. I can live with that. 2 to 4. So if we're really, really lucky, everyone will be healed of their horrible things within 2 days, except for this windpipe thing, which the windpipe thing sucks. But it's not necessarily gonna make them just instantly die in battle like the cracked skull would. Like, these guys' fatigue skills would be so low, they would never hit anybody and they'd just get murdered. Which, there's no point in doing that. Ideally, if I had a couple more men, I could put these people in reserve. Put their armor on those guys. Just have them go to town, right? Is that a terrible idea? I mean, I can get these guys pretty cheaply. But with everything said and done, that's 250. I could switch out their armor so I wouldn't have to buy anything. Everything said and done, how much money will I really get back from it? Will I still be exactly where I am now money-wise? Just desperate and hard up? I mean, I could go out there and not have any fights. Just get paid. It could be simple. I could go out there, get a fight, pick up some equipment. I don't know. He's a beggar. That's kind of worthless. Miller is kind of worthless. I also don't want to buy someone worthless and name him after a subscriber. Be like, oh, you were bought just out of convenience. Nice knowing you. Bye. Move on to the next guy. All right. The waffles are strong. 22 a day, so that's not very long. Not at all. This food is expensive. God, the meat is outrageous. Things are all probably broken. Okay, let's buy some food. How long can I get on being? 3 days. Should I just take the quest? Let's go to the caravan. So I will be going with them. I won't need the food, but I will need the money. How much can I get out of this? Don't need all these shields. Oof. Getting close down to the wire. Okay, it's probably late afternoon, so I should be able just to heal tomorrow. Can't tell if it's midday. Yeah, so we've already paid for today. That's at least something. Let's hang tight for a bit. Hopefully this will heal us a little better. And then maybe in the morning, if things look really good, we'll take off. I'm expecting to get attacked here. I just don't see how that's... Or at least that's what I'm trying to plan for. It could totally be that we don't get attacked, and I'm going to look really silly for this. Only 3 days. Ah, you bastards. I mean, what am I going to do if I do? I just want to be prepared. I mean, I could always just... book it. Alright, screw those guys. This is a 2-skull mission. It's not really anything to sneeze at. We'd be fine, I think, otherwise. But since everyone's just so destroyed, I don't know. Everyone's health is back up at least, except for Mazuka. 50 melee skill. Like, he's not gonna hit anything at 25. There's no point. To really like liquidate everything. I think that's what's gonna have to come down to, is really start selling some more things. Ugh, it's not getting us very far either. I just, in my head, when we run out of money, like 3 people are gonna leave right off the bat, and I'm gonna be really, really screwed. But hopefully one more day. We'll just do one more day. Try to get them in fighting shape. I mean, maybe I should be using this time to travel and find a 1-skull mission, but I feel like you heal so much better when you're actually resting. I have bandages. What else does I have to say? Okay. So we're paused. Let's check people out. God, you're still pretty injured. So some things are starting to heal up on people. That's a good start, but not the fractured skulls. I mean, still a good start. We have people up here that can, like, hit things again. Fiasco, still leading the charge, able to strike people down. Cut arm, melee skill, range skill, not great. Elf Fiend is one of our better hitters, but... will not heal because you have no medical supplies. Does that also include these guys? Ah, shit. Well, shit. Well, that means we're not gaining anything by sitting here, right? So let's take the mission. That probably just expired. Fuck, it did. I mean, I feel like that means that we have to do this contract. Maybe that's not the worst thing in the world. It's better money. I don't feel like nighttime is the right time to do this. Alright, let's just take it. I don't think we have a real choice at this time. I want those skulls to heal, but it's not going to happen now. We have to go out and hunt these guys down. It looks... tracks are thick, but I forgot they changed it. Thick tracks don't necessarily mean they're a large party. It just... so those are the ones I have to look for. What do we have here? Thugs. Some marksmen. We have marksmen as well. Is it still better to go at night? How are our marksmen work? Your skill is decreased, but not tremendously. Your skill is awesome. They probably still have more than us. Everyone's range defense being crap. We're not even going to be able to buy supplies. I hope they drop some. I think we should just play it safe and wait till... oh, it is night. This feels so risky to me. I don't think they have medical supplies there. Maybe they did, and I just missed out, and I'm dumb. Alright, let's do it. Oh, this seems like such a terrible idea. So nervous. I love the way Season 3 is going. I don't want anything to happen to it, all because I wanted to fight some ghosts, and then I ran out of money. Maybe healing all the cracked skulls was just not the right idea, but... I feel like it was the best way to get back on our feet. I want to have some money so I can save and go to a tavern as well. See if we can find any good stories out there. Sounds like they're moving. They might not be moving. Let's see. Can't tell what they're doing. Yeah, they might just be holding out. They outrange us, and I was told that's why they stand there like that. So we had more range than them. They should try to come at us and... or, I don't know if it's more people with ranged weapons, or if we just had a higher range than them, like, tile range, actual range. I'm not sure, I don't know. Seems like they're just waiting, though, so we're gonna have to take next turn and go up, I think. They're hoping the same thing we are. Yeah, look at them. Look at them all just sit there. Everyone's so beat up. I'm sorry, everyone. I got everyone so destroyed. I remember leaving everybody off in a tough spot. I don't quite remember it being this badly. But, like I said, that was some time ago, so... what do you see? Hey, there are some people. Why don't you throw your shield up and hide? You're gonna need it. Who can we hit? 43 is actually pretty good, considering it's nighttime. These people, I feel like, are asking for it. 43, 43. Hit him. Yeah, that's a valiant effort. Don't want to give him this high ground. Maybe we'll just do that. Can't shield wall now, but... I really don't want to give them another bonus on top of me. I feel like they have enough. So they're going to shoot at me. This guy's going to shoot at me. This could be trouble. What am I going to do with you? Let's put you there for now. don't really have a great wall to hide behind. Quote unquote wall, but that's right. You can hit him from here. Great. Your skill's not awesome because you're a cut arm, unfortunately. Because I waited for nighttime. I hope that nighttime pays off for us. Yeah, so far not. I'm hoping. Yasko, you're kind of in the open there. Which I don't care for, but... Ugh, son of a bitch. Son of a bitch. Right, we're not gonna be... Really? It's nighttime. You're throwing shit. Of course you are. I hate to do it, but I might just rush up there. Except for that guy. Because they apparently don't give a shit. They're hitting me. What are you gonna do? Sit there. I hate when they do this crap to me. 31. 5. That's unfortunate. I'd love to kill one of those ranged units. Take a lot of pressure off me. 56. That's quite a jump. I'd rather two of those, though. There you go. There we go. Show them how range is really done. Ah, shit. He's, like, dead. Ah, he's just straight dead. Well, Gizmo, that was nice. Start to this. That had nothing to do with your crushed windpipe, though. You just got shot down at nighttime. I'm not positive what I could have done to really make that better. Alright, let's just get ourselves in there. I think that was our hunter, too. He was supposed to be really good. Or he was from the beginning. No, I think that was the hunter we picked up. So he was a lot of money. Oh, that's pretty cool. Gonna do that shit again, huh? Guess the good news is there's a spot in the back line for you now. You can fit. And we'll eat less food. And people will be cheaper to pay for. And I'm trying to polish the turret that is losing. Somebody I really, really liked on the team. Had high aspirations for. Throw a spear in his range. You're gonna throw a spear. You son of a bitch. Are you fucking kidding me? Their defense is so low, I can't be mad at it. His defense wasn't. I can be mad at that, but these other guys, they are. It's not their fault. Is pretty terrible as well. Yeah. I learned this from the undead. Oh, you fucking kidding me. Get in there. Break that goddamn wall. Oh, now you want to run because someone threw something at you. Okay, where are you? You're at the end, right? Poor Reach. Very happy if we could kill that guy. I'm not positive that's gonna be what happens here. 5% chance, are you kidding me? We should have pushed him off. Terrible play. Rich is probably dead. 17% chance, god, you can't hit shit. Which means you can't hit shit either. Oh, wow. Okay, you got him. You showed me. Can we get you in there to stab this guy in the face? Oh, okay, that turns things around pretty decently for us. I'm really concerned about moving Razor up. His melee skill is quite affected by his pierced hand. However, the opportunity to get in there and poke this guy in the face, the thought of it pleases me. And he's probably just as likely to get shot up here as he is back there. Might as well take that chance and make it worth it. Here it is. Reach leaves. It's fine. What are you doing? You're stuck in there, huh? Your friend was nice enough to footwork out with you. Okay, we got lucky there. Your friend's backing up. Got lucky there. Can we kill you? No. But we'll hold on to the rest of your turn. What else could we have here? 5%, 5%. Not much, not much. I don't think that's going to change a whole lot if we get up, though. I would like to be on higher ground, so let's just do that. Well, it was a nice thought, correct? I think so. He wants to run, so he's kind of not a threat, which makes him lower on my priority list. This guy, he's looking to kick ass and take names. I want to break him. Come on, hurt him good. There's something. Now he wants to run. Good. Let's see. God, you have like no melee defense skill either. Shit. Oh no, you're not the crushed skull. You're just the broken nose. I keep confusing those two icons because I'm slow mentally. Your fatigue is getting pretty high though. Let's put you in a better spot. You're running, okay. Put you in a better spot. Let's see here. See what happens. You run. You get people cut down. Reach is still like, fuck this mess. I got hit by every goddamn attack in the world. You're booking it. Alright, they all might just be booking it now. Which I'm okay with. Quite okay with that. Come on, him in the fat face. Ugh. Pin him down, cool. Switch you out because you can actually hit. 77 is so much better. Nice. Bash his face on. Nice. Nicely done, lads. You mean you can't hit him? How's that? Oh, because you've got like an eye missing. Your range is decreased. Just to put you back in cover then, just in case someone pops out and shoots you for sport. That's the kind of thing that would happen to me. Get him. That's what they do. Get cut down. Nice. Get him. Alright, that might be the battle then. Ugh, horror. Poor Gizmo. Really didn't want to lose anybody, but I knew we were putting ourselves in a very tough situation. We got our item back. Poor guy. Not like that, Gizmo. Wasn't supposed to be like that. No bandages either. It was the life of a mercenary. Alright, crap. Alright, so here we are again. This man wants to buy this thing for a better price. We really need money. Oh, the town would be rather upset with us. That's true. That's true. They would be. But we are hurting for that much money. We're going to get 600, so that's like an 800 difference. It's more than twice what we're going to make. Which I think is typically how it goes. I think that's typically... I mean, that's what it was last time. He's gonna really hate us. But I think we have to do this to get back on our feet. Or at the very least, get back on our feet quicker. I hate doing it like that, but... I don't think I have a whole lot of choice in the matter now. Not with the way things have been going. We need tools. We need bandages. We'll just beat the hell up. I don't think these guys had a lot for us. Duncan Tall. I've been there. So, I know they're giving us rumors to good locations, but I've yet to have that happen. So it was where we were going to head anyways. not positive that that is the greatest advice I've ever had, but whatever. We're in a slightly better spot with money now. So we can afford to take the chance and see if we get something cool. People have been telling me they've gotten some really cool things from it. And lasting in like all game. Oof, another two skull. Another hunter. So I believe hunters have the best range. They're the best ranger class that you can get, a range class. And while he's no replacement for Gizmo, even though Gizmo was a hunter, so he's kind of a replacement for Gizmo. I don't know if we just don't have the money for it, though. This is a good price for this. Maybe we'll have to slide back and become traders for a while. This is a decent price for our medical supplies as well. But see, now we can't afford them. And these things are necessary. We need food. But we do have things to sell. Spears. This, that. This is a nice bow, but the new guy would have a nice bow. Really need this spear, though. I would like to keep it. Despite the bullet and do it. Alright, let's go back and look at our guy, because we really still do need men, too. That's still a thing that has to happen, right? 300 gold would not leave me with much to work with. Let's go ahead, let's do it. I think the time is right. Oh. 3 stars in melee? Star in melee defense? Well, hello, Alfred. If that is your real name. It's not. We're going to change it. You, sir, have a future. Unless I get you killed. In which case, you don't. I really wanted to make you ranged, but good god. 3 stars of melee? I can't think of a time that I've had somebody with that. Alright. Well, of course, now I sold that spear, right? Joke's on me. Joke is on me. Probably we didn't sell the armor. It's kind of shitty armor. It's actually better than what most people are wearing. So I'm kind of glad I didn't sell it. Let's look at what we have in terms of money and resources. Other than the spears I've been selling, you can get one back pretty cheaply. Kind of hate doing that. It feels like a real waste. And I could also give him something like throwing spears too, to really kind of hang out with in the beginning. Get him up to quick hands. Once I get him up to quick hands, I might do something like that. I was being preached the benefits of such things. And I agree, I think there is much to be had from it. Though we sold all those helmets and times of desperation, and now you don't have one. Which stinks a whole lot. These helmets do the exact same thing, but this one is prettier. Therefore, it's like twice the price. I find that funny. I don't know. Sell you. I do know about that. I don't think I need you. Really wouldn't mind selling one of these either, actually, to be honest. Would like to have some money for this to trade. But we might not have that luxury as of yet. There's a quest here, though, that we should be able to take. I just want to find this guy a better helmet, though. I don't really want to take it from somebody in the back line, but kind of feel like that's what I have to do. I'm sorry, bud, but I think it's a necessity at this point that we give it to the guy in the front line. We'll get you a new helmet. We will. I'm not going to let you roll out there with no helmet. We'll buy it. Cheap sack. You can put it over your head. That's armor, right? Can't see the grimace I'm making, so I have to make these choices. Jeez. Might be worth selling this bow. I really want to keep extra stuff around. I do, I promise. But that would... Yeah, no. They'll be dumb. You said that you'd see what this quest is about. See what this quest is about. And level up some people while you're at it. Like Alfred. His name's not Alfred. Actually, Alfred. We're going to be changing that. Okay. So definitely going to up that. As the Bice has told me. This could be worth doing, especially if we're going to make him make... like, give him something to throw at in the beginning. I mean, we could do that now. He doesn't need quick hands. We could just swap it out and have him go to town. 58, that's pretty decent. I mean, what are our other things? Initiative is, you know, it's alright. Health plus 2, I don't think it's going to save his life. Fatigue plus 2 isn't really that great either. Though it's worth considering. Yeah, you know what? Let's just take it. Let's just go crazy. I like that idea. We'll get him the spears. He had spears we could throw. I don't think that's a terrible idea. Now we're back to the decisions of what one of these do we want. Mass adaptation is not a bad skill. Colossus is never a bad idea for a front guy, but his health is only 56, so that means he'd gain like 12 health. And I don't think that's worth the perk over something like 9 lives or faster leveling. I just hate for him to get cut down when he didn't need to be. That's why I like this perk. Though hitting things is nice. Really nice. I have a tough call between this. Tell me what you guys think. I like 9 lives better. I can't say that for sure. It's just, if he died in the next battle, that would be so much money wasted. Yeah, we'll go with that. Let me know what you think. Is that the wrong choice? Should I have gone with that? Should I have gone with something completely different, like Pathfinder or something? I don't know. Alright, Stephen. Stephen, you're faring a little better, knock on wood, this season than last. I'm happy to hear it. Let us up that melee skill a little bit more, and let's get you some melee defense, because that is important, as I am told very often. I wouldn't mind getting you some range defense, but plus 1 doesn't seem worth it. Fatigue's decent, your morale's okay. Your health should gain up on its own, but plus 4 is hard to walk away from. Plus 4 fatigue. Yeah, your fatigue's okay. I'd just like to get you in better armor soon. And that takes fatigue. Yeah. I don't think it's going to make that big of a difference. Hopefully, when everything's said and done. Alright, so you have a flail. A flail's a good choice for this perk. It's pretty nice. Is there something else that's been brought to my attention lately that would be a better choice? What's brought to my attention? Quick hands makes to make people range before things go in. This is nice. Increases shield wall. And increases how much damage your shields can take. I do like this ability, though no one told me in comments that they really like this ability. Doesn't mean that I can't do it. Doesn't mean I can't play the way I want to. By any means. Plus 25% when you already have a decent amount of skill. I mean, that will make a bigger difference. Right now, it would be like 8 points, which isn't a terrible amount, but later that could be really nice. But so is Flail Mastery. I think for right now, this is probably the correct choice. I like this idea, Shield Expert. I like 9 lives. But I think... what is this? Throwing Mastery. Holy crap, damage is increased by 40% when 2 tiles away. Wow, that's pretty awesome. I never even really gave it much thought. Clearly, I barely read it. So I like this, but I rarely use Lash because it just takes so much fatigue. Even with the 25% mana, we should just get it. It's the right thing to do. It'll save him on fatigue. And I should be using Lash more. Tough. This is a tough decision for him. I feel like his range is just going to get better and better. I kind of need a second archer, I feel like. Is it time? Is it time to switch him over? Maybe. Also, I want to put his points into that, like, plus 3 defense isn't that great. His resolve is fine, his initiative is fine, his fatigue really isn't bad either. With that health, what should I do for the last one? I mean, plus 3 in a melee is always tempting, you know. Doesn't really put him that great. I don't know. I haven't quite decided what to do with you and Chetty. You got high health, you got high fatigue. Someone, I think, were telling me to just kind of make you a meat tank. Maybe that's what I should have done. Maybe I should just put the points in here instead of there. You know what? I might just give you ranged weapons, put you in the front with a giant shield. Giant armor, and you just lob shit all day. I don't completely hate that idea. It doesn't leave me with a whole lot of what to do right now. I could give you a bow right now. Actually, I sold them all, didn't I? No, I didn't. I could give you a bow right now. Just let you kind of go at it. Until we get you where you need to be. In which case, I think this might be better than this. This ability. I'll switch you out. Some tough decisions I feel like I'm having to make this game. I don't care for any of them. It's supposed to be fun and easy going. Alright. I think this is a fair position to be in. Let's see what the mission is. I've been roaming around. Bandits, you say? They're about to attack your town in great numbers. We need you to protect us. Be paid handsomely. 1,000 gold for a bandit attack. I do like the sounds of that. I do need some time to think about it. Because honestly, we could use to heal a little bit more. I hope this mission doesn't expire, but we have some money. Kind of. So that. Oh, that pains me. I'm sure it wasn't just me that hurt physically. So I'm sure other people watched that and said, no. Why did you do that? Tough times, my friends. Tough times. Very tough times. But we're still at 10 people. We still have some food. We just need to heal for a little bit. Because we'll have some time after this quest is accepted. Actually, now that these people are here, it might not be a bad time to do it. Oh, they're leaving. How are we looking? I think these would be healed. No, I don't think we have... Melee defense is down. Ugh. Look at this poor guy. Reach. No wonder he broke. His skills are just trashed. I don't even think there's a point in putting him in the battlefield if I... bring him out. He's just gonna get torn down. It's probably the smarter decision at this point. The other guy's crack skull, he died, so no worries about him. You probably won't hit much with your bow. Man. This is terrible. Is this too hard? I mean, I could take some of his stuff now. I mean, your armor's not that great. And I don't really need that weapon, so I guess it's just your helmet. Your shield. Give it to someone better. Give it to the new guy, sure, why not? Let you have your helmet back. And you can just take it easy. We'll take this quest. I'm worried I'm going to run out of money or disappear, and then we'll be really screwed again. So let's see that. Let's see what happens. I think it's the right choice to pull him out. He's not going to do anything in the lines. Okay, we're going to fight in the forest. I don't care for that idea in the slightest. Get out of this town, get out of this town. Where did you go? So fight me out here. Fight me out here. Yeah, sure. So there's not like 20 of them, so that's a good sign. And we're not in a forest. I also really like that idea. You got 31. Yeah, I mean, go to town, shoot wildly. Hit somebody, that'd be great, too. Should I put him back behind? I don't know. Suka, I just don't want anything terrible to happen to you like that. Okay, they are coming at me, at least. That was miserable. Did you see that? Shenanigans. Of course you did. Now I can't even speed a wall because I gotta get you in a better position. Put you up here and bash this guy's head in, please. Ugh. Guys, you guys are killing me. Yeah, there's only 8 of them. We still outnumber them. These guys will go down easily. So I should be focusing on them. Perhaps. Oh god. That just scared the crap out of me. Explains why I couldn't move that guy there, though. It's like, I didn't think I had an opening there. Are you kidding me? Your cracked skull means that you can't see or shoot for shit, doesn't it? Okay. That's cool, though. Okay, you can a tiny bit. Maybe hit somebody for 6% chance. Should just left you out. Should have probably not taken this quest. I have a lot of choices. Hit him. Good. I kind of feel like my back is up against a wall here. Right? Am I wrong? Did I have a better choice? I just don't realize it. I don't know. I don't know what to do anymore. So stab this guy in the face. Or leg, that's cool too. Let's wait on you. Archer's gonna come out of nowhere and take a shot. No, he didn't. Cool. 56. 13. 47. I feel like that's decent. Now, if it was daytime, I could probably be landing a lot of good shots on this guy. I just feel like this crossbowman's gonna do a lot of damage. Hopefully that's enough to really stop him. Good. That's a strong help. For sure. I think I'm okay leaving you there like that, Fiasco. Jump in there. Surround him, huh? Is that your plan? My plan is to stab you in the face. What else you got? You guys don't know what to really do yet. Let's put him down quickly. I like that plan. I like it a lot. Yep. Do you have a cracked skull? You do not. Damage inflicted is down. Max fatigue. Your defense should be intact. King of the Hmong. Okay. Gotta attack a shield. Of course you are. Fuck you. Not my favorite place to be in. Ooh, that changes some things, though. I need somebody down here to help with this mess, I feel like. Because this guy's not going to be very helpful. I don't know, he might get a lucky shot. Or he might just miss a lot. And that's cool too. Well, I'll just miss this guy. No worries, just take your time. He's not going to murder you. You want to run already, huh? That is very interesting to me. See if we can stop this guy. They all broke. Great news for me. Good. Now, let's footwork you out, because I like this position better, and let's see what we can do to this guy. Strong work. Strong, strong, strong. You want to run, so you're not going to take shots. You're blocked. So that makes these guys my best choices. Love to shoot at him. Okay, he wants to run too. So I got 4 guys fleeing. That really stacks the odds in my favor. Miss Yuka is probably going to die. Miss Yaku, not Yuka. He's probably going to die or take some damage. I mean, he's in a good shot to get hit. I left him in a bad spot, but let's see what we can do. Okay, that's something. Repose and shield wall. That's a good choice for you. It is certainly a good choice for you. Surround you for that bonus. Can we knock you out? You probably get a good shot at me for doing that. That probably counts. Let's shield wall you. See if we can knock you away. Perfect. Now maybe we can get you out of there, except you already used your turn. So I don't think that's going to happen. You're dead. Great. That means we can slide you down there and take that spot. Awesome. Let's change this height elevation view. Maybe we get shots off later. That would be kind of good if we could get around him. You gained his courage, but said fuck this anyways. Those two are off. Now you're where I want you to be. One tile away. Where I can't hit you anyways. There's not much I can do about you guys, I don't think. Let's get you over here where maybe you can do a little more. Come on. I thought you were running. Do not make me go over there and have to shoot you. I was done with your bullshit. 5%. Of course it is. And you missed anyways. I'd have been better off just running him up. Fine. I want you down there, but let's chase this guy away. He's going to get a shot off on somebody and just ruin my day. That's what's going to happen. No, 60% chance was a decent shot. Now you got to pros. Okay. You just take a time, breathe, relax. You take crappy shots. There you go. They still want to run. I'm worried they're going to regain and come back to you. Not as worried as I am about other things happening, like him getting a lucky shot. Okay, let's just wait. You can be used later. What can do? Fuck you. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Your height advantage isn't as strong. Hit him. Oh, God, it looked like it was so good. You can't quite reach him, of course. Stab him. Come on, Fiasco. You're my good guy. You're my hitter. Surround him a bit. Smack him in his ugly face. Ooh, this could be a good time to use Lash. Yeah, there it was. Your fatigue's still pretty high. You can be chill. Just chill. Now you got a shot off with pose, but missed. I can't take my crappy shots anymore without possibly shooting somebody. What are you guys going to do? You're going to regain and come back in. That's what I was worried of. Okay. Now we can get you down here and you can take your shot. Good. He wants to run. Fortunate that he's already used his turn. Come on. What are you gonna do? Reload. Shoot. You little bastard. You moved in. Of course you did. As much as I like Fiasco, take that shot. I think he needs to get up here. You can't do anything. And I probably never gave you a shield, did I? Oh, I did. Oh, look at me. Thinking. So you can just chill. Keep it safe. Stop this guy from shooting people by stabbing him in the chest. Good work. Bash his head in. Oh, yeah, there it is. Do it with Lash. It's even funnier. Good job. Was rather positive somebody died. Oh no one's died yet. Good. Not yet. Maybe later. We'll see what happens. Yeah, you're fucked now. You're gonna crack his shield, huh? There it is. Good. Fiasco's gonna crack your face. Look at this guy. Look at this guy wants to come back in here. Fast hands would be doing him all kinds of good right now. Yeah, that was the screen I wanted. I know how to play this game. I promise. Nope. He says nope. I'm okay with that. I'm okay with taking this victory and then it could be getting $1,000 and slowly getting these brothers back together. Alright, got some stuff, some tools. A military pick of all things. Wow, that's quite the find. I don't think I have anyone to really use that. Like, no one trained really to use such items. Well, let's go tell them the good news. Go tell them how great we are. Murdering people, not being murdered back. $1,000. It's desperately needed. You're still being raided? I find that hard to believe. People that need leveled up. No, there was no levels from that battle, unfortunately. Alright, on to the next town. See if we can get a job up there. See if we can not spend all our money on this town like we did the last one. Didn't panic about how we're going to pay for things. Get in there. The Ivan Ravens are trying to take your job. They did. They already did a great job doing it. Lumberjack. An expensive lumberjack. Never hired a lumberjack. Imagine they do some pretty cool things. I want to hire someone bigger and better. Tools are the right price. Food's a decent price as well. Bandages are not the right price. There's certain things here that I'm definitely going to sell. Like that stuff for sure. Take a look at our men and equip them properly. Oh yeah, I know that wasn't yours before, but it is now. A military pack, man. I really like this thing. There's people that have the right aim for it. So nobody was really high, I thought. 68, I mean. Okay, yours is pretty low right now, but normally it'll be higher, right? 68. Oh, 68, I gave you the mace. Herderp. So really, we're talking about Better Lucky. Better Lucky is the guy that has a decent aim. Quite decent aim. Which means he could hit things like this, or even this. This one, F up armor, which is really at times what we need. Is it time to give up the spear wall in the good old, I'm going to actually stab you in the face with a spear trick? I don't think it is quite yet. I say let's hold off for a bit. And just see what happens. I should have done that earlier. Yeah, I like that. I like what we have going on right there. So boar spear, it's better than your spear, so take it. It still gives us something to sell to kind of keep us afloat. We'll keep these things. We'll see where this leads us in life. Picked up some tools. Doing all right. There's no missions for us here. Ooh, it has been an hour. Okay, so we will leave it here. I wanted to make it to next town, find some people, do some things. I want to make this one a little bit longer since it was kind of long-winded at the beginning and dreary. A lot of me moping around about how I'm dying and people are starving. Yada, yada, yada. Anyways, I just want to say thanks for watching. I'm really excited to be back. Thank you guys so much for all the advice you've given me. I really, really appreciate it. I'm excited. I'm really excited to try some of these things out and try new perks, try new builds, make it past 100 days pretty much. So thank you. Subscribe and like this if you haven't already. I really appreciate everyone who subscribed while I was gone. It means so much to me and I'm really excited over it. Tell me what you like, what you didn't like. I love hearing from you people too. But until then, we'll see you tomorrow in the next episode. Thanks for watching.